Hi, this is Matthias. Welcome to another Bitwig tutorial. Today we're going to create an epic effects chain. Well, not that epic, but we're going to create a general purpose vocal effects chain that we can reuse in all our projects. Let's get started. Here I have a basic project with some vocals recorded. I have a lead vocal, a backing vocal recorded that I have pitched one octave below, and a third backing vocal. We can take a listen to the loop first to hear how it sounds with our effect chain applied. You can see that there's quite a lot going on. We have a gate first, a de-esser, an equalizer, some dynamic compression, some blur effect, and a reverb delay, and also at the final stage of the chain we have a dynamic compressor again to even out the vocals. Let's listen.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them, to see unknown waters and just swim with a wave. Just swim.
So that's how it sounds. Let's just first listen to the vocal without any effects applied. I've recorded this vocal take with just the basic Shure SM58 mic, nothing special. I didn't even wear headphones, so there might be a lot of noise in the background. Listen.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them, to see unknown waters and just swim with a wave. Just swim with the whales. Just swim with the whales. You can feel their rhythm.
Okay, so how do we make this sound better? We can first delete this effect chain that I created previously. And let's create a new one, select Bitwig, select containers, and create a chain. And in this chain, we will first add some, maybe the de-esser. De-esser.
You see the light from the ships in the...
It's actually a pretty good setup already from the start.
You see the light.
You can press this monitor to just hear what part of the audio it's listening to. And we have it set to 4.98 kilohertz. We can actually increase the amount a little bit. Maybe set it to 115%. If we set this part to loop, where we have a quite distinct S. And if we remove the de-esser,
To see.
If we set it to a too high ratio, it's going to make you sound very, very strange.
To see.
Like your thee.
To see.
But I think if we set it to maybe 80% or something, it's going to sound decent.
To see.
And after that, we're going to add an equalizer and just get rid of some of the bottom, the low end. a high pass filter, maybe set it to 70-80 hertz or something to get rid of the rumble. There isn't a lot of rumble in this recording, but so we can set it quite low here. I hear there is some sharpness going on up here in the 3K. If your vocal sounds harsh, you can listen to around from 2K up to 4K, and there you will often find that you can reduce some decibels. Let's see where there is, where that is. So around 3.6 maybe. 3.6. What? 3.6 kilohertz. Ah, there. So without our chain. Harsh. Not so harsh. And then after that we can add some basic compression. Set the ratio to around 1.3 and reduce the threshold until you see that it's affecting the audio. Start with the attack around 10-15 or something milliseconds, and the release, yeah, we can let it be around 160. And we can actually listen to a bigger part of the song. The sea, unknown waters, and just swim with the waves. Just swim with the waves. Just swim with the waves. You can feel the rhythm. The sea, decrease the ratio a little bit. The sea, unknown waters. Just swim with a wave. And after the dynamics, we'll add some reverb. I would probably choose Valhalla Room or some other reverb, because the reverb in Bitwig is a little weak, according to my opinion. But for this tutorial, since we're going to use stock plugins, we're going to make use of the basic reverb from Bitwig. And for this, we can decrease the length of the reverb, also the size a little bit. Maybe increase the pre-delay slightly to 10 milliseconds. Let's listen how that sounds. You see the light from the ships in the distance. I think it's a little bit too much, so let's decrease the mix, maybe to 15%. You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be... Decrease the build-up a little bit and increase some of the high end. We can set it to 5.4 kilohertz maybe, and a little higher in the multiplier here, so we get some more sizzle in the reverb. You see the light from the but we don't want it to sound like an 80s reverb, so let's decrease the size some more. You see the light from the ships in the distance. You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want... Actually, we can also add, since there's a lot of background noise in this recording, we can add, before the de-esser, we can add a gate. I think there is a stock gate in the Bitwig plugins. Yeah, there is one. You see the light from... And we can set the threshold, so it's not cutting out our vocal, but rather cutting out the background noise when there's not any vocals present. You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want... You can increase the release time and set it to around 150-200 milliseconds, because we don't want it to cut too sharp.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be...
Actually, we can set it to a little bit less, maybe 125 milliseconds.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters. And just swim with the waves.
And after the reverb, we're going to add a delay. Let's pick the delay too. This is also not one of the best delays, but it can do for now. I have the Native Instruments Replica XT, and it's a very good delay. You can use it as a reverb, and it has tons of analog feel to it. And a lot of great presets for guitars and vocals, etc.
You see the light from the ship.
You can see too much delay going on there. Decrease the high cut and up the low cut, maybe to 390. So we can get rid of the mud. The tuning can be increased a little bit, maybe. And decrease the mix.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters.
And you can experiment by changing the order of all these plugins. Maybe set the delay before the reverb.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want...
Actually, I would also like to make this sound a little bit bigger for the lead vocal. So after this dynamic compressor, we're going to add a blur effect, also a stock plugin, which it makes the mono signal spread sound more stereo. But this is going to affect the whole range of the vocal. We want it to only affect from maybe 500 hertz and upwards. But we can easily do that in Bitwig by adding the multiband FX2. This is splitting up the signal into a low part and a high part. And you can see the point it's splitting here, the split frequency. We set it to maybe 500, and we add the blur effect for the high part of this multiband effect.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters.
Maybe set it to 48%. Not too much, just a tad.
You see the light from the ships in the distance.
Decrease the delay a little bit. Oh, sorry, the reverb. The delay a little bit. And for the final part of this chain, you want to add a final dynamic compressor that will keep all the frequencies in check.
You see the light from the ships in the distance.
And make it only affect the top.
You see the light from... You see the light...
The peaks.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters.
And now we want to add some modulation capabilities, since we're working in Bitwig. And we do that by going back to the chain, the effect chain here. We can close the chain, so we only see the basic chain preset here. And then we want to add some... Right now it's only set to gain and mix, so we can only adjust the mix of this effect.
You see the light from the ship.
We can reduce it.
You see the light from the ships in the distance.
And listen to the total dry vocal.
To be with them. To see unknown waters. And just swim with a wave.
But we also want to make... to add some controls for the reverb and the delay. So how do we do that? We can press this little wrench icon, preset page, and add some more controls here. And if we press a control and drag to the end of the chain, we should be able to see Okay, we need first to add a macro 4 controller. And it's empty at the moment, so we press one of these, dot and arrow. And we can see that we can add controls to whatever we want in this effect chain. But for now, we want to be able to increase the mix of the reverb. And for the second control, we want to be able to increase the delay mix. And maybe we also want to be able to control the length of the reverb. And also the size a little bit. Not too much there. The wrench icon, new preset page. For the first control, we want the mix of the reverb, and the second, the mix of the delay, and the release time of the delay, of the reverb, sorry. And yeah, we can control the gain and the mix of this whole effect chain too. Now we have a lot of capabilities to control this sound during playback. And if you have a MIDI controller, you can set it up to control all these parameters in real time.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters and just swim with a wave. Just swim with the waves. Just swim with the waves. You can feel the rhythm.
Now we can record this, the moving of all these faders by pressing the automation right and just playback.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters and just swim with a wave. Just swim with the wave. Just swim with the wave. Can feel the rhythm.
There, and let's play that
you
back.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters and just swim with the waves. Just swim with the waves. Just swim with the waves. Can feel the rhythm.
If you wonder how I made these second pitch down vocal parts, I just took cut out the regular part. If you press 5, you can get the cutting tool, and then just move it to the second track below here. And if you select the audio event, you can adjust the pitch down here. You can see that it's set to minus 12 semitones. So if you listen to these two vocal takes together.
You want to be with them. You want to be with them.
It's quite a cool effect.
You see the light from the ships in the distance. You want to be with them. To see unknown waters. Just swim with a wave. Just swim with the wave. Just swim with a wave. You can feel the rhythm. You see the light from the ships in.
Yeah, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this tutorial useful and that you can create some great vocal or instrument effect chains now. If you do create some cool effects and want to share them with me, please do so. I would love to listen. Please subscribe and check out my other videos. And yeah, let's stay in touch. Bye-bye.